Good. I would suggest that we get started. So welcome to our diagnostics webinar, Work at Home. So good afternoon, good morning to everyone, depending where you are in the world. A lot of registrants for this particular webinar, so very pleased to see that. Good. Mike, thank you. I'm going to a quick program. We have an introduction about the panelists and the Zoom software, and then an introduction to diagnostics by Mike Pereira. Then we will have a demonstration by Koen van Kole, and then a question and answer session with the three of us, and then some closing comments. Good. So the panel is John Leuenberg, myself. I'm the sales manager for diagnostics. Gert Weissman is the product manager. Koen Portzeners is the solutions architect. Koen van Kole is the one of the developers on diagnostics and doing the demonstration today. And Mike Pereira is our support consultant. Good. About the Zoom software, I don't know whether anyone's used it or not, but if you, since this is a webinar, it's not an interactive session, but what you do have the opportunity to do is in the chat, you can select the chat and you'll be able to type your questions or concerns or anything about diagnostics. So please don't hesitate to ask all of the questions. Good. A reason as to why we are doing this particular diagnostics webinar is because there are a number, with this pandemic going on, there are a number of users at home. Real World wants to contribute to ensuring that people, users of the GE Small World platform, can use it at home. If there are issues, we want to be able to contribute to making sure that you know, the services continue to continue working. People are allowed to do their work at home, and we feel that this is a way that we can contribute in this fashion in as cheap a way as possible. At this point in time, I'm going to turn it over to Mike Pereira. Mike's going to talk a little bit about the diagnostics and give a short introduction on some of the dashboards that are coming up. Mike?
Thanks very much, John. Hi, everyone. Welcome. My name is Mike Pereira. I work at the support desk for Real World Software Products. I'm going to just give a very short introduction to diagnostics, and then I'm also going to introduce the dashboards that the development team created for the work at home add-on. So as you can see on the screen there, diagnostics is an application that it tracks all user activity in a small world environment. So anything that a user does, looking at a menu, clicking on the map, editing an object, committing something, it's all tracked and it's all then presented in diagnostics in a series of dashboards that are easy to understand. Using these dashboards, you can then see what's happening in your small world environment. You can see potentially any problems that have occurred, and also you can see what's happening in terms of user activity, things like that. The focus of today's webinar is the is the work at home dashboards that the development team have created. And these are specifically tailored for tracking remote work. So the situation we find ourselves in, of course, everyone's working at home. It's a different environment. There may be problems and challenges that we didn't anticipate. So diagnostics is there. These four dashboards are there to help in this regard. So there's four new dashboards that are being created and a plugin for the small application. And I'm going to just show you briefly screenshots of those four dashboards. So the first dashboard is the user feedback dashboard. I'm not going to go into too many details about how it works. Koen van Kolen will do that in his demonstration. But this dashboard does what it says, user feedback. It's a way for a user to give feedback to an administrator about problems or even things that they like about what's happening in their small world environment. The next dashboard is the overview dashboard. And this gives a comparison between number of users and how many errors have been encountered. So you can see, well, I've got 5 users. We've had 10 errors. So it's not too bad. Perhaps it's a different scenario where you've got less users and more errors. And you can see that perhaps there's a problem. The third dashboard is the productivity dashboard. Using this dashboard, you can get an idea of whether or not your users are experiencing problems with their productivity, if they seem to be struggling to get their work done. And then the final dashboard is the health dashboard, but this has got to do with the health of the infrastructure that your workers are using. So it could be that your computer at home is slower than your work computer. You might be struggling to get decent response times out of your environment, things like that. You can track that sort of thing, as well as internet connection and so on, using this dashboard. I'm going to turn it over now to Koen, who will do the demonstration and show you a little bit about these dashboards as well as diagnostics in general. Over to you, Koen.
Thank you, Mike. Good morning, good evening, everybody. I'm Koen van Keulen, and I'm one of the developers working on the diagnostics. So this is the presentation part of diagnostics, and we have really a lot of dashboards in this monitor in this menu, and you can use all these dashboards to analyze or monitor your small world environment. And to support the working at home situation, we've added this special menu work at home. And it contains the 4 dashboards that Mike showed. And I will going to show them in more detail. And I'm going to start with the dashboard immediate feedback from users. So everybody needs to work from home at the moment. So it's not really possible to communicate directly and, for example, ask for assistance. So this means slower communication and slower responses. And we've created this dashboard to try to help with this by providing an easy way to communicate between the small users and the, for example, the help desk or the administrators. So this dashboard shows thumbs up and thumbs down. And that comes directly from the SmallWorld application. So we've added these 2 buttons over here. This is SmallWorld 5.2. And a SmallWorld user can click on one of these. So if he's happy about something, he can click on the thumbs up. If he's unhappy, the other one. So, and when he clicks on it, this small pop-up appears, and you can a small user can use it to, for example, say that the small application is very slow. And when he presses this button, it will immediately appear in the diagnostics dashboard. So this is a very quick way for small users to communicate. And when I refresh the dashboard, it has appeared over here. In this table. And in the chart next to it, it shows the most used words in the remarks. So if a lot of users are complaining about errors, for example, it will show up larger over here. The top 5 charts are all for today, but the chart beneath it is for a longer time period. for now it's the last 7 days, and it can be used to see the trend in thumbs up and thumbs down over time. So you can see if it's becoming better or worse. So I think this dashboard can really help with communicating quickly between small users and administrators. The next dashboard I'm going to show is the users and errors overview. And this dashboard is to support small users that are communicating less since they're working from home. And with the dashboard, we try to help the administrators to get an overview of the active users and if they have any problems. So in this table, it shows all the users that are active and how many hours they have been active for the last 24 hours. It also shows the average response times in seconds. So if the average response time is very slow, that is an indication of a problem. Also, it shows the number of sessions that a user is running, the number of actions he has done, and the number of errors there have been occurred. In the charts beneath it, it shows the top errors and overall in the left, and in the right, the top errors by dialogue. So it gives insights into in what dialogues the errors appear or what errors most occur overall. And the next dashboard I'm going to show is the productivity feedback dashboard. We all know that when working from home, people tend to be less productive. Maybe they work harder, but less productive because of bad priorities, or it is maybe harder to focus because you have children running around, for example. So this dashboard can be used to see how productive users are when working from home. So the benefit of this dashboard is knowing what the productivity is of the smallest users, so you can help them to improve the productivity overall. The top two charts, the top two numbers show the total active users and the number of users that did not receive an error. So only one user did not get an error out of the five, so that's not really great. And when I click on it, charts beneath it appear. And the first chart is the number of sessions run by user. So for example, the user root has 9 sessions running, which is quite a lot. So it's already an indication that there is something strange going on. And to provide insights into the productivity, we show the number of database transactions by user. So for example, Alexander did 1, 4, 2, 1, 2, did in total 5 database transactions, but Maria did 3, 4, 3, did 8 database transactions, which is not a lot, but this is my test environment, so there's only testing data in it. But for a real life environment, you get, of course, way more interesting data. And when I click on one of the users, so for example, Root, beneath it, you can further analyze what database transactions the users did. So the user Root did only database transactions in the GIS dataset. He did a delete, 1 insert, and 1 update. So this dashboard can really help you to give insights into how productive your small end users are when working from home. The next dashboard is the health of infrastructure for remote workers. So as you all know, the hardware at home is probably not as powerful as the hardware at work, or your internet connection isn't as fast. Maybe you small users are working via Citrix or VPN, so there's a higher load on the remote infrastructure, and that will result in lower productivity and more frustration for your users. So this dashboard can be used to further investigate how small it is performing on the different machines working from home. So if you can improve something in that situation. In the top of the dashboard, there's an input field which can be used to filter the entire dashboard on machine name. So for example, Citrix. So it only shows the information of the Citrix machines. And the top three charts give general numbers. So it gives the number of application starts on those machines and the average duration of those application starts. And right now it's being red. And so that means that the average duration is getting slower. And it also shows the number of errors during the startup, which is zero right now, so that's great. And beneath it, there are two charts. The chart on the left is the number of sessions by machine. So this can really be used to investigate if the load balancing is done correctly. So for example, on this machine, the Diagtour 200 has 13 sessions running and the other ones way less. So there is something not being done right. And in the chart in the right, it shows the number of sessions by user. So if a small user has a lot of sessions running, that's also an indication of a problem. In the table in the left bottom, it shows the average duration of the sessions by machine. So on the Diag 200 machine, the average duration was not even half an hour. So this is an indication of a problem. And the duration of the machines, of the other machines, is even lower. So this is some cause to investigate it further. And the last chart in the right bottom gives an overview of abnormally ended sessions. So if a session got an error over which it's closed, or a small user didn't close it on in a nice way, so the session ended abruptly, it will show up in this chart. So you can see if sessions are closed in a wrong way or by errors. And if this happens a lot, this is also an indication of a problem. So these were the four dashboards in the work at home menu. Over to you, John.
Great, thank you, Koen. Good, so what we've done, to be very clear, is we have a diagnostics at home, work at home version. That diagnostics work at home version is free. It is license free. We can install it. We can help you install it. It's very easy to install. And if you want the link, you can just click on it. Mike's going to put that in the chat so you can copy it and then just quickly download it. But it's very important to recognize that we're doing this so that we can help users at home with their particular installation of Small World working with Electric Office or PNI or GDO or Water Office, or even bespoke applications. So it helps. You can also see that we have an awful lot of dashboards in diagnostics. Now, they are not part of the free environment, and we can always discuss how you may want to use diagnostics in future. But this is an opportunity for you as users, as small GE Smart World users, to get diagnostics in-house, use it for free. The only cost will be if you decide to use our cloud implementation, then there are some standard costs with related to the cloud, and we only ask that you pay the cost. There's no overhead, it is truly the cost of it. And if you do not use our cloud implementation, then the cost would be having a server available in-house on premise so that we could get all the data stored on there, and then we would give you the dashboards to using diagnostics for the work at home environment. Our hope and our plan is that the experience of work at home will help you and understand the benefits of diagnostics and thus the benefits of improving your small world environment. And just to be very clear, diagnostics has an awful lot of dashboards. We do application tracking, we do database tracking, we do really granular replay user clicks, traceback. It's used for support purposes. The software has been used all around the world to successfully improve and enhance the user experience for GE Small World. Good, we get to the next bit. We get to the question and answer session. So you can go to the chat. If you hover the mouse over top of this Zoom, you'll see a chat button. And in the chat button, you can submit your questions. And you're more than welcome to do that. So I'm going to take a look. The first question, oh, by the way, the email addresses are in there and the link for the flyer. So you can just copy that and download it. And we'll go from there. Good. So the first question, let me see here. So productivity of my remote workers is being affected by various factors. How can my users report this? What can diagnostics tell me about the various factors that are affecting my remote workers, and how can I use diagnostics to make the situation better for them? So Kuhn, besides the kids that are continually interrupting or the pets, could you delve a little bit deeper into the productivity side?
Yes. So diagnostics can help in multiple ways to improve the productivity of small users. First of all, it gives insights into the performance of small worlds and where to improve it. So the performance is better of small world, the productivity of your small users also improves. It also gives insights into what their users actually are doing in the application. So you can fix user errors or help them use the application better. And it can also be used to find out when small users are the most productive. So you can for example, investigate when the best time to plan your meetings and when you shouldn't. So there are multiple ways.
So does that mean, Kuhn, that you can see a trend if something is slowing down, and will that be on the dashboard here?
Yes, we can definitely see the trends over time. If the performance increases or decreases, or the productivity increases or decreases, so you can really see if it's becoming worse or better over time.
Okay. So we have another question. What server sizing is needed to install and run it?
that really depends on the number of smallest users there are actually. So if we can get those numbers.
Yeah, we do the calculation indeed to determine how much data that will be stored on the server.
So maybe if he sends us an email, then we can give him the exact numbers.
Yeah. Good. Any other questions from anyone else? So can we install Diagnostics Work at Home ourselves, or do you have to do that for us?
Well, Diagnostics is quite easy to install. So you can do it yourself, and we have very extensive documentation available. But of course, if you need support or help, just send us an email and we will help you install it.
Great. Any other questions from anyone else? So actually, Koen, one of the things that will come up, and I think I want to emphasize this, is in a remote environment with Citrix and seeing the performance, could you elaborate a little bit more on that?
Yeah, so we measure from all the machines, from all sessions on what machine they're running. So we know exactly on what machine the session is running and what the performance is. So for example, also the Java virtual machine performance, etc. So you can see the performance of the machines, but also the load balancing you can check with diagnostics. And with the standard diagnostics, we have alerts ready available. So if the load balancing is not done correctly, you get an email, for example. And that's part of standard diagnostics.
Okay. Any other questions from anyone else? Can I see what the user did during the error you got in the dashboard? Huh. That sounds like replay user clicks to me.
Yes, indeed. So diagnostics tracks all the user clicks and inputs of the Smolt application. So we've created a dashboard that shows all those user clicks and errors and inputs. And on those on the dashboard, you can, for example, select one of the errors, and it will show you the last minute, I think, of user clicks before the error occurred. So you can see very precisely what the user did before he got an error.
Yeah, and it's probably really important to mention here, when we say replay user clicks, that means everything, granularly everything. So it's important, and I just want to mention in this particular webinar that we see every zoom, every pan, every select, every click, everything that the user does is actually tracked with diagnostics so that we can see how they actually got to the point of where that error occurred. Koen talked about the last minute. We could probably trace back a little bit further if we needed to.
Of course, you can see all the clicks from all users.
Good. Any other questions from anyone else? So I'm creating networks in Small World and working remotely. I find that the response is incredibly slow. Can I let my administrators know of this through diagnostics, and would diagnostics be able to help identify where that problem is occurring?
Yes. So we've created the two buttons in the Smolt application. So a Smolt user can just click on them and tell them that something is very slow. And you can use the diagnostics dashboards to further investigate why it's so slow. So for example, it can check if the problem is in the database transactions, or is it data store reads, or are there a lot of errors, et cetera, et cetera.
Okay. Yeah, it's indeed it's important to for everyone to recognize that we can see every transaction that takes place with every single data set. And we can see what has been changed, what has been updated, what has been read, what has been deleted. So we know or we can see what's going on and where the potential problem might be residing, whether it be with the database or whether it be with some with the network, something along those lines. Good. Any other questions for anyone else? From anyone else? Okay. I don't see any other questions coming up. Oh, we got one. I'm an administrator of several people who currently work at home. I'm receiving reports that they are very distracted working from home. Can I use diagnostics to identify trends and what is distracting them and how to handle this?
Finding out what is distracting them is a little bit difficult, but you can use the productivity feedback dashboards to measure how productive users are based on the database transactions. And also the users and errors overview dashboards to give insights into how many hours a user has been active. So those two dashboards an administrator can use to find out how productive a user is or how much he's distracted.
Yeah. Well, and as you've shown in the dashboard, you can see how long a session's been open and whether it's been closed or whether it's been abruptly closed. Yep. Or when the activity, how long that activity is actually taking place. So we do want to help every user become as productive as possible. And we can see that by the activity. Good. Any other questions from anyone else? I think that's it right now. Good. So we'll close it off. The contact information. Okay. One thing I need to mention is last week we released Diagnostics 2.3. It runs on the very, very latest version of Small World 5, including the new GSS. And at that point in time on Thursday, we are going to conduct another webinar that shows how we link with the logging framework from GSS and Kubernetes. So if you want to know a little bit more about what that's doing, we also have the CRUD in there. So the create, read, update, delete functionality. So Kuhn is actually going to be conducting that webinar on Thursday afternoon, if I'm correct. I think similar time to this, look for the invite. We've sent the invite. And if you don't have it, by all means, send us information at info@diagnosticsandcontrol.com. This particular webinar, among other webinars, are located under the portal tab of diagnosticsandcontrol.com. We've got an awful lot of webinars that we've done since 2017. So there's a number there that you can follow. You can see how diagnostics has evolved over the period of time. And again, if you do have any questions, don't hesitate to contact us. If you want to use diagnostics for free, please send us a quick email and we'll get you on there right there. And you can see that there's a link that Gert has just placed onto the chat, copy the link for registering for that particular webinar. As mentioned before, we have a number of utilities, telecom, gas, electric, and water that have been using diagnostics to help with the performance, with the usability and the user experience, monitoring and making sure that the whole solution is tip-top shape in terms of it working. At this point in time, I want to thank everyone. Like I said, any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us. And we'll look forward to following up with you at any time that you require. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.